Robinson and Stokes proposed another quantitative interpretation of the growth of the activity coefficient at high electrolyte concentrations. According to the Robinson-Stokes theory, the formula of the second approximation should be applied to solvated ions, the molar fraction of which, with respect to the free solvent, differs from the molar fraction of ions without a solvation shell. This, in particular, is indicated by the experimental values of the parameter A, which exceed the sum of the crystallographic radii of the cation and anion. Thus, it becomes necessary to establish a relationship between the activity coefficients of solvated and non-solvated ions. In this case, the same technique is used as when establishing a connection between the stoichiometric coefficient of activity of a binary electrolyte and the true coefficient of activity of ions, taking into account its partial dissociation. The final result can be represented as equating we get since the both of these additional terms lead to an increase in the activity coefficient compared with the second approximation of the Debye-Hückel theory, as follows from experience. Also, the proposed equation as well as the third approximation of the Debye-Hückel theory contains two empirical parameters. It is preferable because the quantity n has a certain physical meaning. If we neglect the second term on the right-hand side of this equation and assume that, then this equation can be written as which to some extent justifies the third approximation of the Debye-Hückel theory. The disadvantage of the Robinson-Stokes theory is that the solvation numbers obtained from a comparison of the experimental data with the equation are not additive for individual ions.